चलो चलो स्टार्ट करते हैं. गुड आफ्टरनून. Alright, so last time we have done up to study note 3, if I am not wrong. Basic concept was done, residential status was done, scope of total income was done, and with that we have discussed one small chapter which was agriculture income. Alright, if you remember that there is a tea, coffee, rubber bifurcation. In rubber we have 65-35, in tea we have 60-40, and in coffee, only grown and cured, we have 75-25, and coffee grown, cured, roasted and grounded, forced process, then we have 60-40. Some bifurcation we have discussed in agriculture income. Alright, that was just a part of PGBP, but because it was given in your syllabus as a dedicated chapter, so we discussed there. Now let us move ahead and continue with the heads of income. Heads of incomes are the core of income tax. Alright, because we have discussed this in section 4 when we were discussing charging section, that there is something called assess. Alright. And assess means we have to compute tax. We have to compute tax. To compute tax, you need to have two factors. To compute tax, you need to have two factors. Total income, and you have to have rate of tax. Rate of tax we have already done in our basic concept. Now our focus is only on total income. And scope of total income I have already discussed, so you already know resident, ordinary resident is liable to pay tax not only on Indian income but also on foreign income. Alright, a non-resident guy should not be paying any tax in India unless and until he is having Indian income. So NR pays tax only on Indian income. And then there is one exceptional guy which is a resident but not ordinary resident. Resident but not ordinary. That person pay tax on Indian income and only one foreign income. A foreign income of which business is controlled from India. You remember all those things? Alright. That was scope of total income. According to your residential status, your liabilities will change. Now, ultimately, after learning all those taxable provisions, we have reached to the level where we can start computing total income. Hello? Alright. And to compute total income, you need to take help of five different heads. First head is income from salary. Second head is income from house property. Third head is PGBP. Fourth head is capital gain. Last head is IFOS. Hello, last head is IFOS. Am I clear? Alright, so we are starting with house property as of now because as I told you, alright, evening we are having GST levy section which is kind of heavy. Alright, so let us finish first only light chapter and only light provision we will discuss today. In house property head also we have two or three provisions which are little complicated in nature that we will discuss in some other day. Alright, house property is one of the easiest head of income that we have in this whole series of income tax. Am I clear? Alright, so this study note 6 is very easy, but at the same time I don't want to lose this integrity. There is the level of understanding that as a professional we must have. So there are two types of understanding in house property people carry. One is computation of income under house property, which is just a mathematical permutation and combination. You just have to do something higher and something lower and then add something and subtract something. Computation of income under house property head is not difficult. Why do we compute house property income in this manner and what not in an ordinary manner? Alright, so there is a whole discussion linked to that. More than 1 hour discussion is designed for that only, that why the hell this head exists in our syllabus. Alright, because I don't think so that anybody sitting here needs an whole head of income to compute income from house property. Alright, income from house property, if I say my rent per month is 10,000, easily you can tell me in 2 minutes that annual rent is okay, 1,20,000. Yes or no? If I say my monthly rent is 50,000, annual rent is 6 lakh. So if that was the case, if this was the case, please understand, then we don't need a head of income to discuss this thing. Yes. We don't need head of income. We are discussing head of income because there has to have something in this head which is not ordinarily understood by people, which is not ordinarily applied by people, and therefore there is a something great in this particular chapter that we have to understand. Alright, and that's a different level, that's a tax evasion level that people have done, and this chapter I called is a chapter of anti-tax evasion. This is a chapter of anti-tax evasion because evading income from house property income, it has been a tradition in India. Many people, 80% plus people who are earning this income, they are trying to evade the tax. In fact, they are evading tax. Am I clear? So we are trying to control it. We cannot nullify it, we cannot eliminate tax evasion, but at least government is trying to control it. Am I clear? Alright, so we will discuss those things, but before that we go into, you know, a detailed discussion of this chapter. Let us do some basic things, alright, that we always do. Income from house property, I hope. Now, I don't know how many people, everyone at least, every bench have these notes? Alright, so at least one bench that, if you don't have, then WhatsApp me your number, alright, I will send a soft copy of this. Alright, but you need to write these things on simultaneous basis, on daily basis. Do not forget that, okay? This is not your study material. Study material is that we are going to make it. Alright, whatever we are going to write will become study material for us. This is just a reference book, okay? So, let us understand income from house property, section 22 to section 27. 22 to section 27. So, there are these many sections we have. Alright, summary of sections. Obviously, this is a list of sections that we are going to discuss. Overall in chapter, section 22, basis of charge. Every head's first section is a charging section. Please understand. So salary charging section is 15. House property charging section is 22. PGBP 28, capital gain 45, and IFOS 56. We have written that particular whole list of sections. Every first section of each head is a charging section. Am I clear? What is the job of charging section? A charging section will give you conditions to be complied. Okay. If you comply with those conditions, then only this head will open the door. Otherwise, you cannot bring your income under the head house property. Am I clear? Or any other head. So, there is a charging section of salary. We say there has to be employer-employee relationship. There must be an employer-employee relationship between payer and payee. If payer is the employer and payee is a employee, then only whatever income payee is receiving from payer, whatever income is received by employee from employer will be taxable under the head salary. So, as of now, I am working under Elite Shiksha on professional basis. I am not their employee. Okay. I have full freedom when to work, how to work. You understand? If there are lectures, then only I can come here. If there is no lecture, I will not be here. You understand? But employees, our staff, whether there is lecture and there is no lecture. Alright. What they should do, what they should not do. It's controlled by employer. Yes or no? Alright. So if there is a control, then there is an employment. If there is no control, then there is no employment. Am I clear? So these things we will discuss in salary head. What I'm trying to refer is that my income, I can, even if I wish, I cannot take it to income from salary because I don't have employer-employee relationship. Okay. Even if I wish, the income that I'm earning from Elite Shiksha now cannot take under house property head. Can you tell me why? My teaching income that I'm taking from these classes, I cannot take it to income from house property. Why? Am I giving them my house? No, I'm giving them my professional services. I'm giving them my if I'm giving them my professional services, the appropriate head for me is PGBP. Hello, the appropriate head for me is teaching is my profession. So whatever income I'm earning has to be taxed under PGBP. Teaching is not your profession, but once in a year if you go and take some seminar somewhere. Alright, so it is not your hardcore profession, but you just took a seminar, one day seminar or two day seminar, once in a year, once in a month. Hello? Yes. Then your income will be taxable under IFOS. Yes. Not under PGBP, because the teaching is not your profession. You are getting my point? None of you is earning income from house property income. Why? You people don't have house property. First of all, you people don't have house property. Sir, but we stay in a house property, but that house property is not owned by you. It is owned by parents. You understand? Yes. And therefore, there are two basic conditions of house property head that you didn't comply. Okay, and what are those conditions? Can you guess? There should be a house property and assessee must be owner of that house property. Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah, sir. So these conditions are there. Once you complied with those conditions, then only our head will welcome you. Otherwise, our head will not welcome you. Am I clear? Okay, let's go ahead. Computation of NAV. Computation of NAV. NAV means net annual value. So that computational mechanism we have in this chapter. Deductions allowed and deduction disallowed. So there are three deductions that we have, technically two, but totally three in this chapter. Alright. And then there is some certain condition. If you don't comply with the condition, deductions will be disallowed. Deduction is the benefit. Alright, that benefit is the conditional benefit. Deduction is the benefit because deduction will reduce your income. Yes. Hello, reduce your tax. Alright, so deduction is a benefit, but that benefit is a conditional benefit. If you comply with the condition, then deductions allowed. If you don't comply with the condition, then deduction disallowed. Alright, then this is the deemed charge section of this particular head. Every head have actual charge section and every head also have deemed charge section. Deemed means you already know. Jo nahi hai, wo bhi hai. Alright, so this is not a charging section, but this is like a charging section because it also have power to tax something in this head. Alright, so that is the deemed charge. This is actual charge and section 25A is the deemed charge. Alright, which talks about recovery of unrealized rent and arrears of rent. So we will discuss that when we reach at section 25A. Section 26 talks about co-ownership. Co-ownership means more than one owner owning a property. So what is the treatment of co-ownership? That we will discuss in section 27. And section 27 is deemed ownership. Deemed ownership means you are not a owner. You are not a legal owner, but you will be declared as owner. You are not an owner, but you will be declared as owner under the head house property. Q sir, why? Why sir? Why? Because people are evading taxes. Okay. This chapter starts with anti-tax evasion, ends with anti-tax evasion. Hello, because people start this head with evasion. If you have this particular income in your life, or if your parent own property more than one, then you must have witnessed this in your house. They take rent in a cash. People take rent in cash. Why? The very basic reason of taking rent in a cash and not in check is very basic reason. Can you tell me that it should not be reflected in your bank account, and they should not pay tax over it. Alright, and that's a tax evasion. Alright, some people are taking it in a check, but they are not taking check in their account. They are taking check in their wife's account or their children's account or their parent accounts. You understand? So some assisted, same tenant will not pay cash. They will only pay check or online transfer. Then they say, no, don't transfer to my account. Transfer to this person's account. So people are evading tax. That is the fact of this chapter. Okay. Government has realized that particular fact, and therefore we are having this head. Whole head income from house property is anti-tax evasion head. Am I clear? Alright. So I'll be teaching you more thing about this. And then there is obviously exempt income. You know, farmer will have farmhouse. Farmer will have one house in village and one house in farm. That farmer's farmhouse, not celebrated farmhouse. Celebrated farmhouse like bungalow and lavish thing. Okay, swimming pool. Not talking about that. Farmer's only original farmhouse where he keep his farming equipment and animals. You understand? Alright. So that farmhouse is exempt. Then temples are having charitable trust, like Ganpati Bappa is also having that temple around him. Alright. So that temple is owned by a religious trust or a charitable trust. So there some incomes from a house property are exempt. The important one is farmhouse that I told you. Other things are just a readable ones. One reading is enough. Alright. So the first thing that we need to discuss under this chart is basis of charge. The first and foremost thing of this chapter is basis of charge. A basis of charge section is section 22. Section 22 says income is chargeable under the head house property, income from house property, only on satisfaction of following condition. Now there are three conditions. These three conditions are not or condition, they are and condition. And you understand and condition? That means you need to comply with all conditions, then only income will come under this head. It's not that there is no house property, has a condition one comply, then I will tax income under house property. No, there has to be house property. In first condition, this word is important. There has to be house property. In second condition, assessee must be an owner of a house property. And in third, please understand, in third condition, all right, such house property should not be negative condition used for own business or profession. Such house property should not be used for own business or profession. Condition one, you understand there has to be house property. Condition two, you can understand to become an assessee under house property head, you must own the property. Am I clear? All right. Condition three is little difficult to understand. So let me explain. Not difficult. It's not clear. All right. So allow me to express. Now Elite Shiksha, this Pankaj classes, they are having 7 properties around this building. Yes or no? 7. They are having 7 properties. Yes or no?
Yes.
All right. As per assessee, you tell me, one assessee or one family of assessee need how many houses? Only one house is enough. Yes or no? Alright. So one house property owner of these classes may be having. Balance 7 property that he is having now. The 7 classroom that we have. Classroom 1 to classroom 7. Yes or no? Alright. Assuming it is owned by owner. What he is doing? What is doing here exactly? What is this? Conducting classes? Running institution, educational institution?
Yes.
So for him, what is this? Is it a renting of property to you guys to allow you to sit here whole day? Or taking lecture? What is more important here? Come on, tell me.
Lecture.
Taking lecture, conducting courses, making you pass? Hello? Hello?
Yes.
So is it a rental income that we are taking from you? Or a business income that we are taking from you?
Yes.
Business income. Alright. So owner of this particular house is using this house property to run his own. So income is taxable, your fees is taxable, but under which head? Think about it. Under which head? Come on, tell me. Our fees will be taxable under which head?
PGP.
Tomorrow when you grow, alright, you will be having 2 houses. I'm telling you, you will be having 2 houses. One is your own house, where you stay, along with your family. And one house you will take to run your office. Hello? When you start your practicing, you will run your office. So you will be having 2 houses. Alright, obviously you are not paying rent for your own house, you are staying there. Alright, and the second house that you are using as an office, you are earning money in that office as a practicing company secretary, as a practicing chartered accountant, as a practicing cost accountant, we are earning money in that particular house. So that income that we are receiving, fees that we are receiving from client, will be taxable under which head?
PGBP.
There is a whole college building. You can go and see that college building, Ismail Yusuf. Yeah. Whole college building is there, whole campus. By running the college, they are earning money. Yes or no?
Yes.
They also have building. Yes or no? They also have building which they use to run their college. They also have house property. That building is a house property. Hello?
Yes.
But that income cannot be taxed under income from house property because they are using the building for their own business or profession. There is a trauma hospital here. You go and check that hospital. Yes or no?
Yes.
That is also house property. There is no difference between this building and that building. This building is also a building, that building is also a building.
Yes.
But that's a hospital, sir.
Yes.
Patient there doesn't come to stay and pay rent. No. Patient come there to get cured.
Yes.
Alright. And therefore, hospital services are more important than the building. So they are running building. In that building, they are running a business of hospital. Yes or no?
Yes.
So rent that you pay as a patient to hospital will not be taxable under. It will be taxable under the head, PGBP. Hello, I'm 7-star hotel, I'm 5-star hotel. In hotel what happens? That Trivago ad, what happens? You go and stay there and you will pay rent for 1 month, 1 day, 2 days, yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, that rent of a hotel will not tax it in under the head, house property. Hotel will tax that rent under the head, PGBP. Because why? Because they are using the building for their own business and profession. You are done with, you understood this third condition or should I keep going? I can keep going like this, unlimited. You understood third condition? Alright, now let us understand first condition. So what I was trying to tell you, whenever you use your building or house property for your own business, the income will be taxable under the head?
PGBP,
not under the head? I am telling you, heads are not choice. Heads are not
choice.
You cannot choose head. Okay, if conditions of one particular head is complied, then you must assess your income, you must compute your income under that particular head. You don't have choice.
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Okay, and therefore conditions are important. So when you grow at CA final level, you will be having more understanding. Okay, CA, CMA final level, then you will be having more understanding about the conditions. Okay, let us not go into more theory here. We'll try to keep our discussion as cut as possible. So house property. So first condition you can see there, note 1, house property, meaning of house property. So what is the meaning of house property? Sir, house property means building. House property means building. Because when I say house property, you people get the image that which comes to your mind is a house. Alright. So they said no, that's building. That's building. House property means building and land upper tenant there too. Land upper tenant there too. Building and land upper tenant there too. Now this whole building, okay, our satellite park have open space. Yes or no? Yes. Yeah, bikes are parked. Alright. So that this land around this complex is the land upper tenant there too. Upper tenant is having meaning attached. It's not visible, please make that correction there. First of all, upper tenant has P in spelling, it's not U. Upper tenant there too. Attached or connected. Alright. To explain that, we have drawn this particular thing. Lightly visible in your book, yes or no? Alright. So this is the drawing that I usually draw. I'm not good in drawing, but still I'll try my level best. So this is open land we have. Then there is a house property you can see. Alright, there is a house property. We have tree here. Alright, we have swimming pool here. You can see my car also. Alright, so there is a car. Okay. Now you are the owner of this house. You own this house and the tenant. Okay. And I want your house on rent. Will you charge a rent only for this house? This is known as building in law. What is the name of this particular point? This is building. This is building. This house is a building. Will you charge only rent of building? Or you will also charge for garden, open space, parking space, swimming pool? Yes. Everything, you understand? And therefore, some of these students are having this understanding. Oh, then this house rent will be taxable under the head house property, and this open plot of land rent will be taxable under the head IFOS. No, because this is not income from building head, this is income from house property. Hello, this head name is income from house property, not income from building. And house property means, come on, house property means building and land upper tenant there too. House property means building and land upper tenant there too. And if this is the building, then this open plot of land or other part, this other land is land upper tenant. Land upper tenant there too. Land upper tenant there too. Am I clear? Alright, so I hope you have written this. Next. Sir, what about this? I have in Jogeshwari or Andheri. In Jogeshwari or Andheri, I have this much open plot of land. Hello, I have Jogeshwari or Andheri. I have 3 acres open plot of land. You understand? And then there is some circus, okay, city circus or Rambo circus, which is about to come in our city. They have taken this open plot of land on rent from us, and rent per month that they are giving us is 3 lakh. So 3 lakh is per month rent, and 3 month multiplied by 3 is equal to 9 lakh rent I will get. Sir, can I tax this particular rent of a land under the head of house property head? Answer is no, because open plot of land is not house property. Open plot of land is not house property. Open plot of land is just a plot of land, yes or no? This is just the land. This is not building and the land. Hello, this is not building and the land upper. There is no building. You understand? To declare a land as a house property, there has to have some construction over it. If there is no construction, then this land is only a land, and only land's rent cannot be taxed under the head house property. Only land's rent will be taxable under IFRS. It is taxable, but it will be taxable under the head IFRS. Am I clear? Yeah. So one point from IFRS is done. Then some people are assuming that, sir, in house property head, only a residential property will be taxable. Alright. In-house property and only residential property will be taxable. It's not like that. A property can be, because when we draw a residential property. But we are saying a property can be residential property, at the same time it can be commercial property. How do we understand whether building is commercial or residential in Mumbai? You people don't have to, because you just walk here 15 minutes. Alright, all buildings are having glasses outside. Alright, those building, huge buildings are commercial in nature or residential in nature?
Commercial.
Commercial. You go outside the building and you look at this building. After ground floor, whole rest of the building is residential building. You understand? So rent, if you are owning one flat here, alright, and that is on higher, so rent of this from satellite is also taxable under the head house property. And if you own one gala or one shop in that 101 mall, Grovels, in mall, any mall, alright, city mall, central mall, you are having two shops there, ownership, and you have given that on higher, even rent of that shop is also taxable under the head house property, because house property can be of any nature. It can be residential, it can be commercial, it can be shop, it can be warehouse, it can be a factory building, it can be any constructed structure. Hello? Alright, so this is how it is. Sir, then ownership. Let us talk about ownership. Second condition was? Hello? Second condition that we have is ownership. Alright, second condition is ownership. So ownership includes beneficial ownership and deemed ownership, that you already know. You understand? Deemed means which is not real, but still it is included in the ownership. How do we get legal ownership? If title is registered on your name, if property is registered on your name. So when will you call a particular property's legal owner? Only if you own the property legally, yes or no? And how do we own property legally? That property's agreement should be on our name. And secondly, that agreement must be registrar in property the registrar office. Hello? So if you have property which is legally owned by you, then only you will be called as legal owner. Hello? In my house property here, we don't follow legal owner. We don't find legal owner. We always try to find real owner. Hello? There's a difference between legal owner and real owner. I'll prove that. Legal owner and real owner. You people are feeling legal owner is the owner. Ha, that owner is paper owner. Owner on papers. But there is always owner who is not owner on paper, but who is controlling everything about the property. That controller person we need to find. Alright, that's the head of income from house property. Before we go into that, there is subletting chart. This chart is not visible. Alright, there is a concept of subletting. Alright, just to prove you that even ownership, how ownership is important, we have discussed this. So let us compute this, okay? We can draw some of our faculties. So this is Dilip sir, a good guy. With a height only you can understand, the Dilip sir, okay? Now Dilip sir is the owner, DV. There is no blue pen. DV is the owner of property. Alright. Sir, show us property. Okay. So this is the property. Alright. So this is a house property. You can see this is a house property. Which is the laid out. Which is? Hello. This contract is known as? What is laid out means giving it on higher. Okay, laid out. So laid out kya hai? To whom? To me. Alright. Why to draw me? Why to insult yourself? We will insult Anjesh. How to draw Anjesh? So this is Anjesh, okay? So this is Dilip sir, this is Anjesh sir. Anjesh sir is a tenant. His photo is not important, his relationship with owner is important. Alright, why there is no face for Dilip sir? Dilip sir, okay. Happy guy with small hairs. So DV is the owner, DV has laid out his property to tenant. You tell me, who will pay rent to whom? Owner will pay rent to tenant, or tenant will pay rent to owner? Thank you for your